Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. Vice President Mike Pence helped announce America's newest class of astronaut candidates on June 7th at Johnson Space Center in Houston. The vice president joined Acting Administrator Robert Lightfoot and Johnson Center Director Ellen Ochoa in welcoming members of the 2017 class, who were selected from more than 18,000 applicants. After completing 2 years of training, the new candidates could one day be conducting research on the International Space Station, launching from American soil aboard American-built spacecraft, and traveling to the Moon or even Mars with the help of our Orion spacecraft and Space Launch System rocket. On June 8th, Acting Administrator Lightfoot testified on Capitol Hill about the $19.1 billion fiscal year 2018 budget proposed for the agency by President Trump. The funding would enable us to continue our multifaceted mission to advance humanity's future in space, broaden our technological capabilities, and make new discoveries about our universe. On June 6th, we demonstrated the unmanned aircraft systems traffic management technologies that we're developing to help the FAA integrate small unmanned aircraft, also known as drones, into the national airspace. The demonstration at four FAA test sites around the country capped off a three-week national campaign that focused on flying small, remotely operated aircraft beyond the pilot's line of sight in sparsely populated areas to help evaluate and refine the technology. The SpaceX Dragon cargo spacecraft that launched to the International Space Station on June 3rd from Kennedy Space Center in Florida arrived 2 days later. It delivered about 6,000 pounds of supplies, equipment, and experiments, including an instrument to observe neutron stars and demonstrate the use of pulsars as a GPS for future space travel. Meanwhile, on June 4th, Orbital ATK's Cygnus spacecraft left the station 44 days after delivering about 7,600 pounds of cargo. That Cygnus, named after late NASA astronaut and U.S. Senator John Glenn, is scheduled to burn up in Earth's atmosphere over the Pacific Ocean June 11th. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on social media and visit www.nasa.gov/twarm.